Almighty God, who has given us grace to celebrate a day like this, our hearts are full of gratitude for all that you have done for us. Into your hands, O God, we commit today's program. It is our prayer that all that we shall do will redound to your glory. This is our prayer in the name of our Lord and Savior Jesus Christ. Amen.
Amen.
Please be seated.
Invite the choir once again to lead us in our opening hymn, school hymn 189. Great is thy faithfulness.
Thank you.
we've met here this evening, but officially we want the head of the school to come and tell us the purpose of our meeting this evening. Shall we receive the headmistress of Achimota School, Akora C, Joyce, and Addo, to come and talk to us the purpose of our meeting and the way for us.
Distinguished guests, fellow Accreds, colleague teachers, students, ladies and gentlemen, I feel honored to welcome you and to prefix the ceremony with a few comments. On 23rd of February 2019, I received a request from the 2003-2018 year group of Accreds seeking permission to honor a teacher of the school. 42 years of selflessness, dedication, hard work, and passionate commitment to the cause of Achimota School. I could not hesitate to grant the approval, especially when the name Mr. Press Placca was mentioned. I felt particularly attached to the ceremony for a number of reasons. First, it is highly remarkable for alumni to hold the ceremony solely in honor of someone who once upon a time was their teacher. This gesture is a very noble one, and I'm certain that this has been inspired by the impact that the teacher made on the lives of these former students. Beyond this remarkable recognition by a group of old students, the school will in due course formally celebrate them among their heroes. I'm also proud to be associated with this short but memorable ceremony because the teacher who is being celebrated today, Mr. Chris Placca, is a proud Accra. In addition, I'm a witness to the values, the principles, and the remarkably exemplary conduct for which Mr. Placca is being honored today. I have been privileged to experience his tireless his dedication to duty, his selflessness, and his sacrifice to guarantee our students' success and promote their well-being. The excellent performances of our students in the WASI exams each year are a result of his devotion to duty. The fame of our school choir and the glory of the boys for us and administrate are testimonies of his sacrifice. Indeed, in our current times, Mr. Placca is literally the institutional memory of Achimota's tradition. Again, I'm very emotionally attached to this ceremony because of the mixed feelings of fulfillment and nostalgia it brings. 46 years ago, Mr. Placca and I were first year students here in Achimota School. Perhaps, like myself, Mr. Placca did not know that one day he'll be winding up an illustrious teaching career in this alma mater. I share with him the fulfillment of returning to serve in the homestead where we have received our basic lecturing in the values and principles for which Achimota School makes a name. As teachers, this short ceremonial gesture is a reminder to us that we do not need to be perfect in order to creditably perform our duties to humanity, especially the duty of positively impacting young lives in our temporary care. 2019 2003, 2008 yearbooks of our friends. We say thank you for not dispatching this award to await Mr. Placca in heaven. Thank you for this honorable recognition here on earth. Distinguished ladies and gentlemen, you are welcome to the occasion. Thank you for coming, and thank you for your attention.
And all of us will join in singing Achimota School in 239. Now please read So instead of doing other praises, Mr. Placca, you brought us here for things we are grateful. We will have a duet, a piano duet by Harrison and Doris.
Thank you. that is a happy work of the Placca. That's it. We're calling as leaders, but they are not music legends. We will have a ministration by the Aggrey Chapel Choir. Maybe we all have to join them as we sing in the glory of the Lord. So, Aggrey Chapel Choir, but they will do a dance conkong first, then they will end with the glory of the Lord. KC will be in charge. Aggrey Chapel Choir. Thank you. page 7, those of us who are in the room, page 7 of that. We continue by inviting Roy Akwadicha, OA 2016, accompanied by Constance Hadidia, to come and perform a solo from Solomon by J.M. Andrew.
Thank you.
these young people came in as leaders, have nothing to do with music. But now, I'm sure in the next years to come, they'll compose their own songs for us. Mr. Placca, welcome. God is bless you. Having taught for more than 30 years in Achimota School, and if you look at the program, you see that all these are the twilight of Mr. Placca. From 2014, thereabouts, up to 2019, very young people, and they remember the man. Organizers, God bless you. I'm sure the future will be an annual program on the OEFA calendar. We'll meet on Father's Day for this. Shall we then invite them to come and give us a word? The organizers, let's welcome him. Yes.
Goodwill message by the alumni of the Aggrey Chapel Choir. The hymn is wrote, rightly be our Father's mercies from his lighthouse evermore. We as alumni and once before students of Mr. Placca are very grateful to God for the life that we have come to know him. We are out there as living waters, reviving thirsty lands in all our deeds. Remember how much trouble we have caused, and remembering how much he will respond brings us so much peace. We are once again grateful to God that we have him in our midst, and we have decided to honor him at such a time as this. Mr. Placca has boosted us in every sense to be better actors, because he believes that to every act and performance, there is much more room for improvement. Sincerely, he happily complimented us. But we grab that as an opportunity to work even harder on ourselves. Yes, he is a great man, and we pray that God will see him through even after Achimota School. In his retirement, we wish him the joy of outward fulfillment and prosperity pertaining to everything he touches. Are you cool, Mr. Placca? God bless you, and most importantly, Happy Father's Day.
Thank you for them. And that reminds me of Accra KB Asante, 92nd birthday at Richard. After all was done, he took the mic and said he wanted to see the kind of people that would gather for his funeral. And he used the second birthday to test that. And on that case, when he died at the State House, people from all walks of life came to honor him. Mr. Placca, we'll not wait for you to die. Not at all. Your work is evident for everyone to see. And these young people are doing so well at the universities, in music, in the choir, and everywhere. Well done, young men. God bless you. We will have a solo asiga performed by Kofi Amwakon, 2015, by DJ Kumsin, and then same performance from Mr. Ken Kavui, Zokebe. Let's welcome Kofi Amwakon.
Thank you.
opening performance to by Jemima Edu Sechua. Just say, we'll give it to you. And Jemima did
And I see by design, Mr. Placca gave me the performance or the platform what the speech is. And she performed. And I looked at you, my man. Mr. Placca, you are better than who is the You have the eyes and you have the face to start young people. We will meet you. Achimota School is beautiful. We will miss you, sir. After school, some left far and wide. You stayed to train. And for 30-something years, non-stop, day and night. Mr. Placca, Allegro. We want to invite the Holy to come and give us a word in honor of this maestro. Can we invite the Deputy President of the Holy Akora
is talking about? In December, during the carol service, and I thought it was a good idea, but it was meant to be a surprise performance, to surprise him. But surprises can be torture, because how to keep this thing quiet from Mr. Placca was a mission to us. The rehearsals started secretly, I won't say where, and the momentum built up. Then at a point, an announcement needed to be circulated. And I told him that this is the end of the surprise. Because someone is bound to tell him, or he will see it on one of the numerous platforms. So then he had to be told that something was going to be done for him, but he didn't know the content. So too bad. He has been the backbone of music in Achimota School for many years. We all know that those of us who come to the carol service, the memorial service, Founders Day, name it, anything musical, and Mr. Placca is there. It's a good thing he didn't praise his students because they would have been so headed. I don't think they would have been here. But it's a good thing too that they didn't take it to heart and actually thought about honoring him. And like Father Ajiman said, we didn't have to wait for him to be motionless and tell all sorts of curious stories about him. His work has paid off. His students' talents have been harnessed and they're going to grow from strength to strength. Once a teacher, always a teacher. So I don't think Mr. Placca is going to stop teaching. And I'm sure when he hears something, he'll be itching to tweak it a little bit here or a little bit there to make it even better than what they're doing. So Mr. Placca, don't sit still. I know you can't. We do have a few arguments about being selection during a memorial service, but it always turns out well. He has his views, I have my views. But some way, somehow, we come to a compromise, and life goes on. The attendance at carol service, for example, speak volumes of your input. So, Mr. Placca, once again, on behalf of the OAA, I say Ayeko, Tumadokuwa. And to the planners, thank you for coming up with it. Even though there was a hiccup in the beginning, I'm sure we've all forgotten. And the performances have been worth the wait. If anybody disagrees with me, it's raise their hands. So thank you very much for your patience. Thank you, Mr. Placca.
Oh, we will be grateful to you. We thank you so much. Your grace and mercy. Another powerful song. But you love Anna. I guess the mass choir will perform this for us. Alumni choir will perform. The composer is here. Yes, you love Anna. Please, shall we acknowledge you? Oh, yeah. That's a powerful song. Sarah, yes. Powerful song. Thank you, sir. I'm grateful. Let's enjoy it.
Thank you.
if I can cut me. Is it like I cut you around? No. Okay. The Alumni Choir. Whatever touches you we'll do it in honor of Mr. Placca. But I also thought it was his Father's Day, and we don't have to jeopardize the atmosphere. We go to honor Mr. Placca. The young people have put something together. And this year is for Mr. Placca. 2019 will be his best year. Oh.
So in dissension, being in the Aggrey
renounce the UEFA Championship, what is it mean here with us? To tell Mr. Placca he will never walk alone. So let's hear from our celebrant.
Marginalized. We wants to bring these things, but despite all these challenges, as Professor School, so it's hard to maintain that system, that tradition of doing co-curricular activities. And I'm learning so much from co-curricular activities, because in the past, when we talk of co-curricular activities, they were activities that led to professions. Apart from, right now we are made to believe that it's your eight subjects you learn in the classroom that makes you what you are. In those days, we had co-curricular activities, and people made their professions aside their books from co-curricular activities. The cadets were produced wonderful army officers, all the Achimotans, a lot of them became there. The music school produced musicians, and all these we were doing as hobbies. We were just doing these things as hobbies. We took them for granted, and eventually we decided to take them up. We had national hockey players as students. Students were national hockey players as students. The Bazanfons were cricket players when they were students. Professor Francisco was doing sports, all for fun. And he ended up taking it professionally to the extent that he represented Ghana in the triple jump, four Olympics. But these days, it doesn't exist anymore. It's learning, learning, learning. The school administration are being forced to, bracket their brains to get a school calendar. But it's so difficult. There's a league table out there. Please ignore that league table. It's not, it doesn't reflect the pedigree of Achimota School. People have become criticized that for why we have this. If you look at some of the schools, I bet you, pardon me, but the Asian Taparas can jog around the schools in 10 minutes and not get tired. I remember in one of the league tables, the school of 56 students, when Achimota was presenting 950 something students that year, they were top. They don't do co-curricular activities. Over here, tell them, those who do the league table, we teach traditional dances. We teach army discipline. We teach people how to march. We teach people musical instruments. We teach people how to sing in the choir. We teach people French and German. That's Founders Day every year, not like once in 10 years. We do speech day every year, not once in 10 years. We have singing competitions. We have gardening competitions. We do production play. Achimota conducts operas. We produce operas. And so many others. Ignore that big table. If we're doing a holistic education, that's what I want to do. And openly said, they bring us weak students. Students with poor grades. So he was exposing the system. We thought it was on merit, the placement was on merit. He stood here and said, we bring weak students to Achimota School. We deliberately bring them to test your teaching prowess, to see how well you can transform. You say you're in good school, we see how you can transform students into good material, village students into good material. And there are hundreds and hundreds of them in this school. We are 3,500 and counting. We present over 1,000 students for what sits every year, and you want to make comparisons. And some schools, the only co-curricular they have is preparing for science and maths week. I'm told in the typical standard schools and in the semester, receive all the best. They're still doing that practice. I thought that practice was stopped long ago. Achimota doesn't have that luxury. Some of us, there's just about 1,000, we are 3,500. We are under siege. We are not allowed to listen. A lot of students keep coming in, poor grades, yet we are accused of poor results. This is what's going on. So we are appealing to the Ministry of Education to take a close look at co-curricular activities, balance them too. That's what made us, after all, we are the same people teaching those in the new, it's our knowledge that we are impacting those in the new system. So I got my help out for those SS students who have made it out of this system. We have really worked hard to, a visual arts student who wants to pursue that course is doing 8 literature books. This is not part of this. So when we have a 7-year course, we're doing 3 subjects. And when we have now a year less, we are now doing 6 subjects, we've added 5 more subjects to the 3. Can you imagine? How do you compare the 2 products? Certainly the old student, the old system was much better. So we are appealing to the Ministry of Education to this. Right from the primary school to the this, what I always say, sleep deprivation. It's a very serious matter in life. We don't talk about it at all. There's no siesta for students. They are always learning. The little child will get up, go sleep the house at 5 and come back home at 4:50. Activities, learning. And despite all these challenges, Achimota School is still maintaining its traditions. We are doing as much as we can to give our students a holistic education. So we are appealing to the Ministry of Education, take a second look at the education system, reduce the number of subjects. That is the main thing. We always attribute. Thank you. So thank you very much. I want to introduce Mr. Alexander Osei, Mr. of Kampo. So Mr. Alexander Osei will be taking over for me. The one piece of advice I will give you is beware of Akoras. Beware of Akoras. They will keep you on your toes. They will criticize you, especially at events like this, services and all that will come to you every time. Hey, I'm not saying this can't be anymore. This is all the thing we know. Your dressing, everything. But most of all, the support. Thank you very much.
Mrs. Mary Wood. Akora Gloria Amati Pani. Akora Mini Dabu Asante, representing the Queen of Santa's family. Akora Kusi Oppong. Very happy on the plate. Thank you all for coming. And Justice Mrs. Mary is also the niece of Gabe Yasant. And I'm Gabe Yasant's grandson. Thank you all for coming.
Father's Day will be here the whole day with you. Clergy, God bless you. And to my chapel workers, behind the scenes, young people are working. We're grateful to all Aggrey Chapel workers. God bless you. On that note, we'll take a vote of thanks for the alumni, anyone to do the welcome for us. And then the clergy will give us the closing prayer.
The headmistress of Achimota School, the inviting guest, all people of the we want to thank everybody for making it to this program. In fact, we are very grateful. We thought it to ourselves to honor him, and it's been a blessing having you guys around, or everybody around, having everybody around to join us celebrate a wonderful person, one who has really impacted so much in our lives. We pray that everything you have lost to be here this evening, the Lord himself will replenish it. Thank you so much, and have a wonderful evening. Thank you. Shall we humbly ask that we stand and pray? Shall we bow our heads and pray? Father and my God in heaven, we thank you for creating music in us. We thank you that you are watching we enter into the realms above. Our voices will join those of the archangels. We shall celebrate you with our music. We thank you for blessing us with a musician. Thank you for the life of our brother, our friend, our classmate, our teacher, our mentor, our music director, Accra Chris Mensa Placca. We thank you for the number of years he has been associated with Achimota School. We thank you for the things you've done through his music to nurture lives and to soothe our hearts. Moments of challenges and difficulties. Thank you for the family behind him, and thank you for everyone. We felt your presence in our midst, but Lord, we're going home. Tomorrow is a working day. We commit ourselves into your hands. Lord, we ask that you help us into yourself. Cover us with the blood of the Lamb who died and rose again, and is coming back very soon, that we shall get home safely. When we go to our beds, we ask that grant us good night's sleep. So Lord, we pray that as we go through this
weak. Let your mercies be upon us. Let our country Ghana into your hands, and we ask that. Let your peace prevail over this land, that we can meet and have such celebrations and worship services. So the Lord said to Aaron, tell the priest, whenever he has to bless my people, this is what he must say. And when he has said so, I will bless my people. So beloved in the Lord, this night, the Lord bless and keep you. The Lord lift his face upon you and be gracious unto you. In the month of June, in 2019, this very week, when the Lord has lifted his countenance upon you, may the Lord grant you peace. Go in the peace and in the blessing of the Lord. And may the blessing of God, the Father, the Son, and of the Holy Spirit be with you, remain with you today and always. Amen.